Get your voice heard. When everybody is out there on the streets just waiting to go viral, you have another opportunity. And that is to come to Anchor.fm. Download the free Anchor app and join us here at the What's the Play family. And make sure that you DM us here, Steven, at Who Cares the Podcast, or go to info@whatstheplay.net so you can join our family. We'll promote the shit out of you. We will promote everything about you. Make sure you're cool. We're not going to promote some of you weirdos. We're going to make sure we promote you, because everybody needs their voice to be heard. Everybody during this time needs that voice, right? Don't you need that voice? You could go global tomorrow. Just join Anchor.fm. Go to Anchor.fm to get started, all right? But make sure more than all that you join the What's the Play family. Info@whatstheplay.net will help you set it up, will help you go through all the situational things that you need to do. And tomorrow morning, we'll make sure that you get your voice heard.
Warning, the following video contains strong language which may be offensive to some viewers or inappropriate for children. The content within this video is intended for mature audiences only.
Do you play Call of Duty? Then it is your duty and obligation to go to what's-the-play.myshopify.com. That's right, it is your duty and obligation to go to what's-the-play.myshopify.com today. Men and women's sizes available. Go get your shirts today.
Welcome to the Who Cares podcast, a podcast that enters your soul with your host, Stephen Moraga.
It's time once again for the Who. The bloody sex version.
Oh, I can't wait.
We have in studio again, it's the Who Cares podcast, starring me, Stephen with a PH, and the lovely Miss Southern Belle-ish.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, Southern California Montebello.
It doesn't matter. Southern California, we found out, is actually really a nice place.
It is. Better than all of the other rest of California.
So we started with Miss Southern Belle, Miss Meg Lee.
Good to see you.
Good to see you too. We have been getting so much feedback because last week was a very tumultuous podcast.
And I was just listening to it and I thought, oh, I hope, like, you know, we kid around a lot and we're not like, we love all
our listeners.
Listeners, races.
We do.
I mean, yeah. And we just like to kind of.
Because we're like a mix of all of them.
Yeah, exactly. And we're a minority.
Yes, ish.
You know? Half my
I'm just kidding. We're all minorities. No, but
the point is, like, we come off.
We're just not.
We tease a lot. We kind of joke around a lot, and we don't want to make it seem like
we want you to write into us.
We don't want to make it seem like we
hate our listeners.
We get no.
But some of those mailbag questions last week were very, very mean spirited. I felt.
Yeah, and I felt like it was people that we knew, and then we were kind of like clowning on people.
Do you
that
think we
knew? They sounded very close to people that we knew. I mean, I don't know. I mean, I'm just thinking that maybe it could have been people that we knew and disguising themselves. I don't know. It just, the stuff that they said.
Yeah, it kind of hit home, huh?
Like they knew, yeah.
So. Well, speaking of hitting home, I kind of went home a little bit.
Oh, that's right. You took a trip to Vegas. Huh?
I did take a trip to Vegas. But before that, I unfortunately or unfortunately, your win a date with Stephen contest.
Yes, that's right. I was going to ask you about that because... It was the last time we talked, the last show, we figured out the winner.
It wasn't the last show, it was the show before.
It was Tedessa, though. Yeah, it was the show before. Tedessa, who was way outside your age, margarine.
Margarine?
Margarine? I mean, margarine. I guess you didn't call butter. It. I guess you didn't call it margarine because, like you said,
she was a butterface.
That's okay. But okay, so she was a little outside the what you're normally
comfort zone.
Yes. She was 42.
Yes,
which is maybe ten years outside your
a little bit.
But
10 years.
Ten years outside your no.
Yeah, 15, I would say.
Oh, 15?
I don't date over like 25, 26.
I know, okay, I know. I forgot. And so, but.
Thanks a lot.
Vanessa from El Monte, how was she? How was it? How did it go?
Well, the reason why we didn't talk about it is because the night that we recorded last week, the podcast we're recording today, the podcast came out yesterday. Whatever.
I know, you were going to leave for Vegas the next day.
But right, so I went on went on this fucking date that you set me up on.
I'm sorry. It was a quick, I'm sorry that it was short because you had to get up early the next day, but how did it go? How was she?
Because I wanted to kind of make it, what if it happened that I didn't want to leave, so they kind of have that feeling of, I got to go on my plane tomorrow.
Uh-huh. Babe. Yeah, yeah, you were.
I don't want to leave you. And then kiss, kissy, kiss. No, don't leave me.
You were dreaming.
As soon as I get back, baby, I'll call you. You know what? That's exactly not what happened.
I think you're already prejudiced the fact that this person was outside your age range.
Yeah, that may be true. Well, I walked into the... Okay. You're right. But I would think you've known me for a long... Since we were children.
Was she a young 42?
I don't even know. Is there a young 42? Is there? You're not even touching 42 yet. Okay?
And it's right there. Yeah.
No, it's not. you're not even close to it yet.
Enters your soul.
And you're beautiful.
Oh, thank you so much.
But
Teresa, what?
But I hope to God, Megan, you stay the same. You stay the
I
same.
I do too.
Because I don't know what happens at 41.
I'm going to kill myself.
I don't know what happens at 41 or 42 or 43. I don't know. But you better, whatever procedures you do, whatever stress-free life that you live, that gives you such beautiful complexion, that is the exact opposite of Teresa.
Well, she came from El Monte. She probably, I think she's been working. Well, I'm just saying, from what I heard, in her little background report, she works two jobs. So that's double, it's probably hard to get any sleep.
Hey, have you ever thought about being a podcaster like myself? Well, you can't be like me, but I want you to be that innovative, that wonderful, spectacular voice that the world needs. But you got to come to the What's the Play family, because we moved over here to Anchor. We left Spreaker behind and we moved over here to Anchor.fm, because Anchor is your one-stop shop for recording, hosting, and distributing your podcast. Best of all, it's 100% free and it's ridiculously easy to use. And now Anchor can match you with great sponsors too, like myself, so you can get paid to podcast. So remember, go to anchor.fm/start and join me and the What's the Play family. You know how to get a hold of me, and make sure you do it today, because I can't wait to hear your podcast.
And I think she has a kid, I think.
You know what's happening right now? The next Win a Date with Steven contest, nobody will want to enter.
No. I'm just saying,
you guys had
a good time, but there was something that bothered you. Like, what was it?
Her age. Her look, her dress, her attire, her accent, which wasn't even Hispanic accent. It was...
Did she speak English?
Yes, I guess. Because we do have a Hispanic white accent, right? And it sounded like there were glimpses of that because she was born here.
Yeah.
But that doesn't even matter. I love accents. I love Hispanic accents. I love when I go to Mexico and my little darlings, I start speaking Spanish overnight, mm-hmm. Brazilian, Portuguese, Japanese. Look at these.
You're basically naming all the people.
Everybody.
all the escorts.
Everybody has a great accent except for this lady.
Well, hold on a second. I just got an update. I'm sorry to tell you this. I don't want to tell you this before, but she was actually 10 years older than she was.
Oh, that totally makes sense though.
I didn't want to say anything.
She looks fucking great. Then you tell. Wait, hold on. Then you're telling me we could have gone to like.
I didn't want to say because we had it open to all ages, and I didn't want to tell you that because I thought you'd be definitely like you wouldn't even show up. So I just I wanted to let you know that you did go out with a 52-year-old woman.
She was not 52.
Yes, she was.
What the.
Yeah. So how? I mean, I wanted you to experience.
Well, then now that makes. I would have been like, damn, bitch, you're fucking. You're doing all right for 52.
You know, we don't. I didn't want to say anything because you would have totally not even shown up.
You know what? If she would have been nice.
She wasn't nice?
No, she was nice. I can't say that, but I mean.
Please don't tell me that you left during the appetizers.
No, I didn't do that. Not this time.
You didn't
time.
Do that move, okay.
You know, where I'm like, oh, I got to go to the bathroom. And I just leave the one.
Yeah, please don't tell me that you did that move.
I didn't do that. There's a place over here, Matsu. Uh-huh. They have a little sushi bar.
Yeah.
So any girl that. Once to win a date with me again, you probably end up there again too with me. But I promised myself after I left that night that I'm not going to allow this lady to ruin Matsu.
Yeah.
I promise. I love their fucking sushi. They even have giant clam, which a lot of places don't have. And for everybody out there that doesn't eat sushi, giant fucking clam's the best.
Really?
Yeah, it's like a, this is the texture of it.
I just want to say though to everybody out there, octopus,
she was a giant,
yeah,
she
octopus was, yeah. Have actually, they're very smart. They have brains.
So
please don't eat octopus.
I eat octopus.
Then they feel emotional trauma when you eat them.
Is that what happened?
Yeah.
You know who I didn't eat? Teresa.
You didn't? And that's like your favorite thing.
I know. I love women's vaginas. And I love to be down there for
early. You didn't even try. You didn't even make a move.
Fuck no.
Wow.
I figured I'd battle cobwebs. And I'd have to battle like, you know, remember Indiana Jones?
Yeah, and you know, I loved Indiana Jones. I liked when he went through those like cool cobwebs and had
these. Yeah, do you remember like the Haunted Mansion at Disneyland? That's what I pictured.
Isn't that fun? Like you go through like something scary, but like, oh, you're like,
whoa,
oh,
it's an oasis.
Wow, it's actually fun. Never mind. I had fun.
It's like Splash Mountain.
You didn't even try.
Splash Mountain.
Oh.
No, it wasn't Splash Mountain.
Could have been tight too.
This is what I think about dating a woman that's like about, well, now she's 52.
She's probably
42, 52.
Probably how many years?
Right. No, I think once you reach a certain age, there's a high probability that she has herpes.
She never got tested. Possibly.
I mean, you fuck long enough, you're going to get something.
Maybe she stopped fucking a long time ago, though.
Okay. Well, the older I get, I feel like I have enough time in life.
Yeah, yeah.
To have to date older women.
Yeah. Like when you get there.
When I get there, right. There. So there's a whole other episode to this fucking person's life over here.
Yeah, okay.
So you just tried to skip past everything for me, yeah. And you just fast forwarded it.
I just wanted you to get that experience. I mean, you know, well, it wasn't me.
I've never
it
been
was
a date.
It was
a
luck of the draw. That's what we drew. But I did. I didn't tell you.
No
that.
Offense,
it was
Teresa.
Open to all ages.
No offense, Teresa.
And I didn't. I didn't want you to.
If you're listening,
be exclusive
Teresa.
To your usual age category. I wanted you to
get outside my comfort zone.
Get exactly.
That's so nice of you.
You know. Yeah.
You're just such a giver. All I know is that you're usually one of the greatest wingmen, wingwomen.
You know, because I like older people, and I thought maybe you should experience the same thing.
You know what? We all don't have the same fucking beer taste, champagne, or beer pocketbook champagne.
You know,
taste.
Like 40 years old. I know. I just thought it would be like something to try out, you know.
Well, yeah, that's
you
cool.
You might like it.
Yeah, it's cool. I could get Pabst Blue Ribbon or possibly.
You never know.
Or I could get a nice IPA.
It could have gone either way because what if you decided like, oh my gosh, this was, oh my gosh.
Okay. That would open up a whole other door?
This is, yeah.
Okay. I'm like, so then I have a bigger spectrum.
Yeah. I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm totally now like 50 and above.
Yeah. So that would, if that were the case, if you
would, it might have blown your mind.
All right.
It might have blown your mind.
That's fair. That is fair.
You might have been scared, but you would have tried it and you're like, oh fuck, this is what I've been missing out on.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Well, you know, because I have enough friends that they will jump on grenades like that. And and they've told me that, you know what? You never know.
Okay, but like, say any friend that you've had, what's the long, like the age difference?
Oh man, I know friends that like when I was like 21 were dating like 42-year-olds or 45-year-olds or something like, because the girls are hornier and they know what they want and blah, blah, blah. Well, you know what? I'd rather play the game of stupid and dumb myself down for a good 15 hours to get to that fucking beautiful honeypot.
You know why it's different?
You know what? I call it a honeypot. under the age of 30.
No, I you know, it's weird because guys mature.
Hashtag
like,
honeypot.
Guys mature slowly.
We do.
Like slower than girls. And that's probably why when I was like in my early 20s, yes. I wanted somebody mid 30s or above.
Right,
because
right.
I thought like they're a man. They're not like guys.
That's why we got along so well.
Guys below that age are just
I'm 5 years older than you.
Guys below 35 when you're 20 are just child.
Well, and like I told you about my doctor telling me, my actual doctor that I had when I was a kid. Yes, he ran into some legal problems later on, but that's okay. But he really encouraged me to date at least 6 to 7 years younger.
You have
because maturity-wise, that's exactly.
That's totally true.
Oh, well, that's true, but you'd set me up on a fuck. The other did the other two look like?
I thought maybe because you weren't having any luck with people in the age group that you were... You know,
I was getting kind of
girls
jaded.
That were like 20 or
I was getting jaded
and I thought, okay, maybe you need some older experienced person. So let's open the age category.
Yeah.
Well, and I thought that maybe she would do all the work so you wouldn't have to like,
she's
you could be relieved.
She's a 42-year-old liar.
I don't have to do all the work here. I can let some older, mature woman
fuck
do
me.
All the work. Yeah. Fuck you. Exactly.
Show me what's up.
But I guess that didn't happen.
No.
No? No?
No. Cause you know why? I know TJ Maxx has a lot of good clothes. Conceptually, I understand that. But there's a lot of bad clothes there, too.
Did you get your dishes done, at least?
No, but I have a great house cleaner now.
See? So it wasn't all... It wasn't, like, all a waste of time, right? Exactly. And that's what I've been trying to tell you.
Well...
Something good could come of it.
By the way, Teresa's going to be here in about 15 minutes to come clean the house.
You know what? At least she's an honest, loyal...
Look, I tried my hardest. I asked her about, you know, real subjects. I'm talking about...
I know. You're talking jaded. You're jaded.
I'm talking about physics.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking about...
You gave her algebra?
No, I don't know algebra, but I'm talking about real life stuff.
Yeah.
Physics. I was like Stephen Hawking.
And what did you tell her? What questions
I was Stephen
did you
with a PH
her?
Hawking.
What question? I know you like to give girls...
I said, look at... So what... What happened in your life to make you like this? Can we talk deeper about this?
To like this, that you were already just kind of fucked her up by that.
Yeah. Tell me a little more. Like, were you abused?
So basically they're saying, why are you so fucked up?
Were you molested? Talk to me about this. Let's get deep. Can you pass me that potato skin? Just kidding. They don't have potato skin.
She's like, no, I just
have. Can you pass me that giant clam?
Oh, man. You told her this and she was just like, I just had a... Kid at 20 and I...
Yeah, he's now your age.
And he's now... I didn't do nothing. I worked on my life to get to...
Oh, if you knew that she was going to be like that, she wasn't that bad, but you are a...
No. I wanted...
You're a sneaky little bastard.
I did not know. I opened it when I found out the winner.
So, okay.
When I found out who the, like...
Yeah, the winner was?
The winner was.
That you picked the winner. What do you mean?
I didn't pick. It was...
Between those three. Teresa,
no, it was
Evangelina
down to those three. It was actually like
Han Ting
viewers or listeners
who
actually picked. It was kind of like a draw. It was either pick 1, 2, or 3. Okay. And she happened to be number 3 and they picked number 3. I didn't know who number 3 was going to be until I saw. Oh. But I did
what
know.
What kind of math are you doing?
But I did know it was open to all. Because I didn't want it to be biased. So I made sure. I didn't know that. Because if I saw that, I didn't want to like, oh, okay, this person is this age. Get rid of it because I know he only likes this age group. So I had to, it was like a blind, basically, study.
Yeah,
so
exactly.
I was blind.
Anybody that go on a date with her would be blind.
And basically, it was just about numbers 1, 2, or 3. Pick
motherfucker,
1, 2, 3.
You know how much, how pissed I was.
And number
at you?
3 happened to be somebody that was 52, yes. But,
but
and
told
I thought,
to me it's 42.
You know what? Hey. I thought like, you know what? This will be good for him.
That's right.
And
hey.
You know, outside your comfort zone. You needed to be outside your comfort zone. When's the last time ever, or when's ever a time?
I was in Vegas.
You've ever been with somebody outside your comfort zone?
There's been many times.
I don't think you've ever been with anybody like that's been...
Not that age.
Over 20 years older, 20
no,
years...
No, 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 no.
Okay.
But I mean, outside my comfort zone, I'm talking about looks-wise. I don't think they deserve
I'm
to be with me.
I'm talking about age-wise. Everybody,
many times I've been on my comfort zone.
No, but everybody, that happens to everybody after so many drinks, right? But this is like age group.
Yeah, there wasn't enough drinks in that motherfucking matzu.
There's definitely, you've never been with somebody that's been
shout out to matzu.
20 years plus older than you, right?
No. I've never been with anybody over the age of, there's only one girl that, because she was close to my age, So let's see. Yeah, like 32. Right. So yeah. But we dated in high school and stuff like that, right?
Well, I thought this you had to
it was
have,
an ex.
You had to have the experience.
I have not been with anybody over the age of 35.
And I thought this was the time. This was the time.
35.
This was the time that you should.
Like, well, you know what? There's going to be a lot of time for me to do
because
that.
Because there's a lot of people saying, like, a lot of guys that are, like, hooking up with older women.
During this time of crisis, Megan.
Older women that say that older women are, know what they're doing.
If she got COVID, she would have died.
Maybe she would teach you a couple of things.
She was
maybe
really,
she would teach
she
you
told me how scared she was. That tells me right
did
now.
Did she teach you a couple
honestly
things?
Honestly, how scared she was?
I thought maybe you could learn some things about, you know, I thought, oh, this might be a good learning experience for you when I found out her age.
I don't mean to be, I know you've had an emotional, but this girl was not far behind. She had to worry about COVID. And you know, you and I both were
well,
not.
I thought you were.
You and I both are not worried about it.
I thought this because okay. Based on your previous experience, you weren't able to take pleasure in people like.
Right. Oh, I get you.
Okay, so mm-hmm. I thought maybe this was the drastic change mm-hmm. that you needed.
That's true.
Because you never know.
Who, you don't.
You know what I mean?
That's,
like some people are like, oh my gosh, I never would have even tried it.
I think what is it? You Pierce know? Brosnan? Is he with an older or Hugh Jackman?
Yes, he is.
He's a good-looking guy. Everybody loves him, but he settled for...
He's gay. And I can tell you that. That's the truth. And that's the truth. That's the truth. And I'm not saying this based on any kind of bullshit. That's
what's
the truth. And I have an inside contact.
Hypothetically. Or what's
I'm sorry to break this to you guys, but...
yes, he is in musicals. Yes.
He is?
Yes, he did... I think the Tony Awards. I
he's
think he
homosexual. Hosted. Come on, people. Okay. Come on. And I'm sorry, but you know what? Let's not judge him because he's a good action
okay,
star.
Okay, so give me somebody that's with somebody that's older that it's worked out for. It didn't work out. Ashton Kutcher, for instance.
Okay, yeah. Women, I don't think older women with guys, I think they'll eventually get tired of it, but they can at least have sex
and,
with
and
them.
And Ashton Kutcher
they can have sex with them, though, in the meantime. Like, Ashton Kutcher should not have married Demi Moore, but they could have been fucking buddies for a while.
And that's fucking Demi Moore, who was smoking hot back in the day. And still,
she's one of those ones that's just trying to hold on to her youth by trying to.
And it looks pathetic. We know
it
that.
It does.
But guess what? I wish what's her name Teresa was trying to hold on to her youth. She didn't give a fuck.
You know, there's a lot of like beautiful like classic.
They take pictures.
Classical
good?
Actresses.
They take good pictures.
I think are.
Greta Garbo.
Like Jenna Rollins. I think she's
Betty Davis.
So no, not Betty Davis. But Jenna Rollins is a pretty older woman.
Who the hell is Jenna Rollins?
Cassavetes, John Cassavetes' mom. You never see Jenna Rollins? Look her up right now.
Oh, yeah.
She's beautiful.
Oh my God.
She reminded me of my grandmother, but I think she's like.
She's like your grandmother.
But
she's
got to
be beautiful.
She's beautiful. Like,
she's
like your grandmother. An older woman, because I thought, wow, she's a good looking old woman.
Henry Rollins? Is that what you said?
Jenna Rollins.
Oh, John Rollins?
Jenna.
Why does it put her as John?
Maybe that. But Jenna Rollins.
Jenna. I like the name Jenna.
I always thought she was a beautiful older woman.
Oh.
You know? Young, older, like she stayed beautiful. Even as an older woman. Like I thought, like.
Oh, okay. All right. I see.
You see her?
There's
like,
pictures
as an
of her.
Older woman, she's a good looking older
first,
woman.
Hold on. First of all, she's 85 years old.
Yeah, and I think she's a good looking 85 year old woman.
Okay. There's also pictures of her maybe like in her 70s. Uh-huh. But I get what you're saying.
Yeah, you're right.
But now she's so.
But I haven't seen her.
But now she's so old.
Okay, but yeah, like then, see, because she was in that movie with Jared Leto.
Like that, right there.
Yeah, even okay. Like in her 70s. And, yeah,
and, but then, you know, 80.
Her younger, too.
But then right? 80 happens.
I know.
Age is a motherfucker, isn't it?
I think I'll probably, I mean, I've always imagined myself dead at that time because I don't want to imagine.
Yeah, but you know what? I look at our parents and their ages, like before, if they would have been just born 20 years before that, they'd be cotton ball heads, you know? They would look like those old ladies that we grew up with. Our parents look amazing. Your mom is beautiful. Your dad is a handsome man.
Like, even my grandmother.
My mom is beautiful.
I'm not going to be like, I don't think, like, I think.
Like, they can still dye their hair and it looks natural.
Yeah.
Like, you're like, no, they should have gray hair by now.
Hell no. Like, my mom and I and my grandmother were like, no woman should ever, ever let their hair go gray.
What about,
I don't care if you're like all
hair?
Free. An older woman should not have long hair either. Past their fucking mid-back.
Are you gonna have?
Hell no.
Are you gonna cut it?
I'm gonna. I thought about shaving my hair only because I've damaged it so much with bleaching.
That'd be cool.
I was gonna let it grow from the beginning. You know what I mean?
What if you shaved it like when you were like when you turned 65 or something like that, right?
No.
You shave it and then you bleach it. Like who is that lady?
Okay, here's another thing. Because I see people at the hair salon Those are like, okay, yeah, if you're tall and like skinny, you get away with that.
What?
But the short, where you don't look like a dyke, you can still get away with looking like.
You think you look like a dyke?
I could not.
Sorry,
do,
excuse
I,
me,
no,
lesbian?
Yeah, I could not. Lesbian? No, I could not. No, yeah, the short hair, when you're short and have short hair.
Jamie Lee Curtis?
When you're short, when you're 5'5 and below. Short hair.
Who's a young actress that cut their hair recently?
With the girl from Black Widow.
Yes, her.
What's her name? Scarlett Johansson?
Yeah, no, you're right. That sucks.
Like, you can't look like, it's hard enough to look like it. No offense, dykes, but there's.
No, we don't. We know that you guys have bad relationships with men.
You have to look like, you have to be tall.
No offense against lesbians, but we know why, you have a bad relationship with a man.
You know what I mean? You have to be like. A tall supermodel to have like short hair, you know what I mean?
You are a tall supermodel.
Like your mom is
tall. You have to have
light.
You have to have light eyes.
And you have to have light eyes. And
like you.
You have to have height. Like your mom is good at height.
I feel like we're the same size.
I feel like your mom is good at height.
I'm 6 foot. How tall are you?
5'5".
Really? I feel like you're not.
I felt that way too until they measured me at the doctor's office. Oh yeah, no, you're fine. I'm like, are you sure? Maybe like am I setting
up
right?
I've never thought of you as short.
Yeah, I'm sure. Yeah. You know,
like for a woman, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah, I'm totally short. Yeah.
No offense.
Like
for a woman.
Me and my brother, we didn't get my dad's side of height.
Yeah,
we got
tall.
My mom. We got my mom's side. Yeah, she's 5'2".
You and your mom both walk exactly the same.
Yeah, you know.
You and my brother. You do. Aunt noticed that. He's like, "What the heck?"
Yeah, but, we're like tomboys that are gonna like we act like we're gonna start some shit, but then like we don't.
And then your mom acts younger than you. Like not in an immature way.
Mom, calm it down.
Not in an immature way, because your mom is definitely like this is.
No, I know she totally.
But when you guys were standing next to each other, and you were like looking, she was sitting down, and she's like all bubbly and cute and stuff, and then you're like looking down
like
on her.
Like I lived life like too long.
You're like, mom, hey, we gotta hurry up this.
Mom,
up.
Do you realize that my kids are way worse than me? My brother were. I'm like,
mom, we got some things to do today.
Okay? I gotta deal with the fucking kids when we leave here. You know, the kids that are tremendously difficult.
It's so amazing.
I know. I'm like, wow. I'm like, now I get.
You are the adult in that family.
I feel like, oh man, she told me, oh, you're gonna get back what like you guys.
You unleashed on them.
I got it. I'm like, oh man, I now I know. What she must have felt like, because I was always telling her what to do, even when I was like 2 years old. As soon as I started talking, I was like, hey, give me this. Leave me and dad out of this. Like, we're trying to work here. Can you just go? And she's like, what? I'm like, yeah.
And she was probably like, oh, sweet about it. She's like, okay.
She was. I'm like, oh my gosh. I was like, how? Wow.
Your parents.
And my brother was like her little help. Like, he was my
son. Oh, no.
That's why I always got
like
more trouble with
elf.
Her. I always got more trouble with her, and he always got more trouble with my dad.
This is the helper song. Mr. Rogers, he used to have a TV show way back in the day, and his mother always said to him when he was a little boy, if you ever get in trouble, look for the helpers. They'll always be helpers. So whether you're 10 or whether you're 87, life can get tricky sometimes. So the trick in life, one of the big secrets in life, is to look for helpers. So we say, find a helper and be a helper. And that's going to make everything better for you. So here's our helper song. We're going to say, where are helpers? Where are helpers? Here they are. Here they are. They're sitting right beside you to help you and to guide you. Be one, two. Remember, find a helper, be a helper.
My dad and I are like, shh, it's fucking morons. And then
like, oh, he's like,
deal with this.
He looks at you and goes, can you believe I married that girl?
And we're like, we look at each other, we're like, we got to deal with this shit every day. Like, I was too. He was like, we got to deal with this shit every day.
He's like, it's a good thing I have you, Megan. You deal with your brother, like, your brother and your mom.
I don't know how you do it, Dad.
Well, speaking of hanging out with your parents,
I did a family vacation.
It was a wonderful vacation.
That's cool. Because I was wondering how I was going to go because, you know, you haven't
been with my parents.
Or a family vacation. Like,
I haven't been on a family vacation probably. When God, I don't know.
Because you saw your cousins, your aunt.
Everybody.
Yeah.
Yeah, my aunt moved out to Las Vegas, and then my cousins moved out to Las Vegas as well. Her son and his kids.
How long ago was it? Like
a year and a half ago.
Oh, so it's been that long since you've probably seen them, right?
Yeah, it's been like 2.5 years since I've seen them.
Wow.
Or not my aunt D, but the kids I hadn't seen. We were all talking about it, and it had been a while. I'm like, really? Well, time flies because it just seems like.
Are your cousins older than you?
No, they're the ages of 16 to 19. And a shout out.
Oh, that's your second cousin. Right?
Shout out. Yeah, what were they? Yeah, I guess it'd be my.
But your first cousin.
Oh, Tim. Yeah, he's turning 50.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so he's definitely older than me. He's the oldest in the family.
Oh, he's the oldest of all the cousins?
Right. Okay. He's at least, 10, 15 years older than me. But I don't know if he's 50 or not. Like, he's having a birthday. I don't know. I wasn't paying attention.
Oh, gosh, yeah.
I don't know. Like, it could be 45 for all I know. But to me, it sounds 50. To me, it sounds like Teresa.
It's the end of life. It's middle age.
Whatever age he is, he does look younger and stuff. In fact, it's hard for me to say this, Miss Bagley, but in his prime, he was probably by far the greatest looking
cousin
of all of us. He looked like like a damn Brad Pitt.
Wow.
My other cousin Nick talked about when they would go to the mall here at Lakewood.
Yeah.
The girls would be like screaming and like falling over themselves.
He was a jock.
No, he just was very good looking.
I mean, just saying, like, basically, like what we typically see, like the jock and all the TV shows, like, you know.
Yeah, whatever TV show you saw. Whatever TV show you saw, he was better looking at.
Wow.
And then, so I didn't realize that till later on, But then, we all, he's still a good looking man. I'm just saying, like, and it's very difficult for me to say this.
You're kind of saying, like, but when you say but.
But that's why.
You say but. He was a great looking guy, but.
Well, I mean.
I hope. Follow
up. No, because then I started maturing.
Okay.
Yeah, and then I started looking good. I wasn't this obnoxious Afro-headed kid.
But did he have thick legs? Because it's hard for guys.
I have no. Oh,
did you guys have thick legs?
You're a dick right now because you saw my picture. And if you want to see my picture, compromised picture, and you can go to Instagram, Maraga Steven, check it out. It's me in the hotel room, and I got snapshot it. I guess I didn't have to post it.
I guess you're gonna make every fucking woman out there jealous because
yeah, but you told me I had skinny legs. But you told me I had skinny legs.
Every girl's like, fuck, he's got fucking skinny legs. Good ass skinny legs.
My good ass skinny legs. Is that
my skinny legs? I can never get skinny legs. Every woman's gonna be like, what the fuck? Fuck him and his skinny ass legs.
Every woman's gonna be like, oh, I thought he was good.
Fuck him and his skinny ass legs.
Yeah,
show off. Yeah.
And I've been going to the gym lately.
You know what? There's two types of guys, mm-hmm. and I've noticed this. Mm. Ones that have skinny legs, like my brother is very tiny.
Brother's a handsome man.
And I picked up his boxer briefs. I'm like, how could any tiny ass, unless it's like a 10-year-old ass, fit in these tiny? But their boxer briefs, I'm like, wow, his legs and his butt fit in these tiny things? And I guess
that's what we do.
And that's the one. Yeah. And then
we can fit in all kinds of stuff.
And then there's like.
Like because I want to say one thing real quick. The fact that every year you buy me jeans, fantastic jeans every year, that it's just amazing that you even think about me. And but what's funny about that is when I remember the first year you asked me my size and you're like, what the fuck is wrong with you?
Are
you
like, I've never even like, because my grandfather was really skinny. He was like, even my brother, like, wow, even they're small of a size. They were like 32 and then like, I'm like 30, 31. I'm like, that's who? And it's usually the size, which is a good thing when you shop because nobody's that size.
What are you talking about? Those are the ones that get.
Those are the ones that are so open.
Like, no, those are the ones that are taken.
Oh, no.
No, you can get 36s all day.
No. 30 and 34s or something. They have a plethora of those sizes. But if you go 32 and above, because everybody's like that. But 33.
You know who I wish had the 32s or 30s? Teresa. But for some reason, Megan, you fell for her fucking pictures. She's very photogenic, like somebody else we know.
Well, you know, it reminds me back like when I was in high school too, because I was like wondering, because this one girl, like, she had a super thin face, and it was so crazy because you never would have thought, like, you know, some people like different, they have different builds, and no offense,
people
but
do
this
have
was like
builds.
One that she always had a skinny face, but when it was like even a small waist, but it was like when. Like, it was from the below the waist. It was like, whoa, what? Like, you never would have thought, like, it was almost like somebody mismatched, like, the top and the bottom. It was so weird. Like, you know what I mean? Like, and that's fine, but it was like, whoa. Like, I couldn't believe how crazy that could be. And
I can. I went on a date with one.
Because, you know, usually, like, you know, you're used to, like, okay, somebody's chubby, they're chubby all over, or somebody's skinny, they're skinny all over. But when you get, like, a half and half.
I'm so happy that I didn't have to take her all the way back to El Monte.
What happened? I don't
even
know.
I'm so glad I didn't have to take her all the way back to El Monte, and that she met me here at my house. That's what I did. Well, she won a date, you know?
So you didn't even go down to, like.
And listen, to all the female listeners.
He's not judgmental.
Just don't have, if you're not very attractive, that's okay. Maybe we'll do a Miss Meg Lee makeover on you.
And don't have a mismatch.
You know what
I mean?
You know what? That's the thing I'm going to do. Miss Meg Lee, I'm going to give you like a guy and a girl to makeover. And Miss Meg Lee's makeover.
Yeah, okay.
And you have to take anybody out there that's feeling a little rusty.
Yeah.
Feeling a little not looking your, because after COVID, you know, people gain weight, or they, you know, or they didn't go to the gym. So yeah. I think this is the time. I think this is, wow, this is pretty good. Miss Meg Lee's makeover.
Okay.
All right.
But here's the thing.
No,
though.
I pick them.
Okay. You're going to pick them?
Fuck yeah.
But here's the thing, though.
You take them.
What about when you have a half and half?
We will spend the whole budget on them.
When you have a half and half, like.
What do you mean half and half? Like the lady.
Like when your upper torso is not. Is way.
Are you talking about the girl from your high school?
Is way mismatched. Well, in the way you're telling me that your date was.
I'm not going to get the girl from high school for you. That's what,
I'm saying, what if they're mismatched on the top and the bottom?
Well, then that's on you, Miss Meg Lee, who purchases beautiful jeans for me every birthday. You know, I'm gonna give you a little harder test this time.
Oh, that's okay.
All right,
wow.
Here's a test.
Yeah, that's.
You get them to look like you. You create miracles.
Get into fit into 30 or 31.
Whatever you got to do. Whatever you got to do. You got to. You better get them fucking pants hemmed.
Get him to get.
You better go to goddamn Taylor.
As good as legs as you got, like right there. Okay.
Better take. No. You gotta find the right. You know.
Yeah, I know.
Fitting form. I know. Yeah. You know. I mean, look at you. Always dress beautifully.
No. I. So basically, you're saying.
No. This is. Now I did what you did, which you asked me to do, and I went on a date, and I really pretty much wasted a whole Thursday night.
It was not a waste.
No.
It was a learning experience.
I know that I never want to see a 52-year-old again.
Maybe 62.
That isn't my like related to me. Okay? I know that I don't care anymore.
I hope the next contestant that wins the date is.
I don't know why a 52-year-old will be listening to our podcast.
Is going to be in her like very early 20s, and you're going to find out like, wow.
Yeah, wow, I'm getting married.
Wow, I kind of miss Teresa.
Wow, we don't have the podcast anymore.
I kind of miss Teresa.
Well, we don't have the podcast anymore because I'm married and I don't care about anybody.
Teresa, can I get you pregnant?
No, I definitely couldn't. You know I couldn't. Her eggs were definitely the long time.
And that was another thing I thought would be good because you wouldn't have to worry about wearing.
Yeah, did she go through the change already then, motherfucker?
Well, probably. She's probably at
that. Really? You sent me on a date with somebody that went through the change?
I didn't want you to have to worry because I know you don't like wearing condoms.
That's so true.
Yeah.
We didn't have to worry about that.
I just thought something more like older and refined.
Let me just tell you, the sushi was
nice.
The sushi
wine.
Was fresher. So anyway, so Vegas was a fantastic adventure. My dad and I golfed with my second cousin Chris, Tim's son.
Everybody, you had a good time. Like you missed.
Oh, it was fantastic. It was really beautiful. Like, and my aunt Dee, we woke up when I did stay one night. I stayed at a casino right by there. But one night, the first night, I stayed at Aunt Dee's. So yeah, so I saw my cousin Tim, his beautiful wife Kathy.
Oh, how long did you get married?
I don't know, how old are the kids? Like 20.
That's the same mom of his kids. That's cool.
Yeah.
Wow, that's cool.
They're all from there's the one family.
That's good. No, that's
cool. I don't know. This day and age. Okay, so you haven't been in the longest relationship then.
Yeah.
That would be one that I know that's still going strong. So the kids were so sweet. They had a charcuterie tables and I mean of salami and I mean it was amazing. And these kids are, you know, I know how I was at 16. I was a piece of garbage. No, I wasn't that, but I mean I thought a lot about me.
Yeah, yeah. Well, you were going kids. Through your rebellious time, right?
Right, right.
Well, how...
How were you at, oh, at 16? You were still demanding everything from your mom and dad?
I knew more than my parents. And I was their parent, and I was like...
I think you would have had a charcuterie table out like they did.
Yeah, yeah. I was bartending my mom's 30th birthday at 10, 12 years
30th?
Old. 30th? Yeah, 30th. I was like 10 or 12. Yeah, more, yeah. My brother and I were bartenders. And I was like, can I be bartenders?
Hilarious.
So, like, I didn't know the concept of, like, because I didn't
pour.
So I was like, oh, gin, you want gin and tonic? So I poured gin and clear. So, like, right. Oh,
it's like water.
Yes, yeah, so I. Everything's wasted at that party.
So, you're doing the same thing?
Yeah, it's
just still pouring like that.
I'm like, oh, it looks like, yeah. And I'm like, just a little bit of gin. I'm like, that's cool.
A little bit of gin?
Yeah. I'm like, I look clear. So I thought, how bad could it be? Yeah, no concept. Yeah.
Everybody probably felt the. They got
axes
on the way home. They ran into like curbs.
I'm thinking to myself, wow, I can't believe
they woke up with other people. Like the whole party probably woke up with somebody else.
You know, but that's the chance you take when you get your kids to be the bartenders at 12 and 10 or whatever.
Like how many of parents' friends woke up with the other person's wife, I wonder.
I was just like, I can't even believe we're bartenders.
I can't either. So okay. Vegas, great. All that family stuff, great. The one thing that's crazy... is that, you know, when you're with your parents, you love them. But thank God that I got a room, you know?
Absolutely.
After, you know, because, you know, I mean, I haven't lived with my parents for, what, 20 years? Or
yeah,
no.
No,
not 20 years.
I know.
Yeah, a long time.
My parents, whenever we go on family vacations, have always gotten separate rooms for me. Like, my brother and I would take one room, and since we were, like, probably 13.
But.
Because we were like, yeah.
Well, it would be nice. Well, here it goes again. The beautiful life that Megan had again.
Like, just a paradise. I think it was like when I opened the dorm one time on them.
Well, you know what? Not everybody can live the life of like of a 1988 film where everybody's just having a great time and stuff and everybody has money.
I know. Now, you know what sucks is that when you realize that, like, oh, why am I not getting like... the guy that Molly Ringwald got, like, in 16 Candles.
Right.
Like, or
Ducky?
No, when she got that, no, that was 16. So Kind of Wonderful. Did you ever see that?
No, I never saw it.
You never?
I wasn't allowed to see those kind of movies.
It was, like, rated PG.
I don't think I was alive then.
You never saw Some Kind of Wonderful?
And you're younger than me.
Oh, my, you never saw that movie?
Who's in it?
Eric Stoltz.
And everybody just left the podcast. Whoever that is, all right? I know who he is. He was in Pulp Fiction. He was the redheaded guy, right? I know
that. The only cute redheaded guy.
He played that mongoloid. He played that mongoloid biker kid, right?
The only cute redheaded guy I've
Wasn't
ever
he
seen.
A mongoloid in, already, with Cher? Right? Because we've been on the topic of mongoloids.
The cutest redheaded guy you've ever seen.
You know what I'm talking about? That biker movie?
Yeah. Yeah, I do. Mask.
Mask. Mongoloid Mask.
It wasn't Mask.
In case anybody didn't get it, the reference, it's Mongoloid Mask.
The cutest redheaded guy in show business.
Yeah, it looked adorable.
Well, he was really cute. Like, and he goes for, like, basically, I've always been, like, where the cute guy goes for, like, the girl that's not the popular one. Like, uh-huh. He shuns the popular one to go for the girl that's, like, the tomboy girl.
First of all, Molly Ringwald was a superstar.
No, when she was in 16 Candles, she had short hair. She looked like a tomboy. She almost looked like
look
a
at
boy.
It, look at you're like totally. You're totally.
I thought like that
putting
was
yourself in that position. I can't think of the word. You're totally putting yourself in that position. That must be you.
It's gonna happen.
It did.
It's gonna...
And you're on this podcast with him.
Like Jake Ryan, I'm gonna get.
That's his name, Jake Ryan.
Jake Ryan was in 60 Candles. He was like the hottest guy in school, and he dishes popular cheerleader girlfriend to be with a sophomore, short-haired.
Wait. Oh, you're telling me he ditched to be with a sophomore? I think I've done that too when I was a senior.
He ditched sex because Molly Ringwald was like a virgin sophomore.
No, what a great
short
guy.
Hair, super short hair, didn't wear makeup or anything.
What a great guy.
And he ditched his hot girlfriend, who was like the most
popular. A senior. She was a senior, right? And she's a sophomore, right? And she still has many years to go, right? That's kind of what you did to me. You put me with Teresa, and when I still have many years, I could go for the sophomore.
But, like, Jake Ryan, like, even his friends are like, you're going to be, what?
They don't know, you know?
Like, who?
Yeah,
like, what?
That's ridiculous. I think that you guys all called him Prince Charming for doing that. I call him fucking the smartest man in high school.
She wasn't at her prime.
Doesn't matter. He's the smartest man in high school. She's a virgin. He knows that she can grow her hair out. Right? Is that?
Yeah, exactly.
He can mold her into however he wants her to be.
Because people also made fun of how flashy she was. And
oh, I love that. I love small boobies. Dude, what the fuck kind of movie is this? Like, I would just call it Duh. That's the movie. Oh, you want some trashy-ass senior bitch who's been like everybody, like the whole goddamn baseball team and shit? Yeah, she may be hot right now, but like she's on her way to like smoking cigarettes, drinking beer at O'Flanagan's down the street.
And there was another one that was even better. Okay, so kind of wonderful. Eric Stoltz, who was good-looking. Yeah. He was in love with this high school senior girl who was, everybody was in love with her. She's Miss Popular. Mm-hmm. And he had this friend, and she was like...
Yeah, right? See? Awesome, probably.
She wore boxers, too. Boxers.
Fuck yeah. Girl, I love it when girls wear my clothes.
She was in the locker room with the other girls, and she was wearing boxers, and all the other girls wearing panties were looking at her like...
That's all right. I love it when a girl comes in my... you know, honestly, that is one thing that I really... I don't like a girl getting into my shit at all, right? But when she comes, like I'm just down here maybe working in the office, right? As she comes down in my boxers and one of my faded shirts, she looks and, like, her hair is pulled up.
When's the last time that's... I know Teresa might have done the same thing. She might have brought in your boxers.
Teresa, there's nothing Teresa could have done. She was you set her up for failure. So real quick, Vegas trip. I love being around my family. I think it's amazing, but also then there was my Vegas. Because I got a couple rooms.
Drink to me only. That's all I ask. And I will drink to
how long I've been on.
I don't care if the sun don't shine. I do my drinking in the evening time when I'm in Las Vegas. You can sit in the sun and camp. I get my color from a sunray lamp when I'm in Las Vegas. I love the laughs and love the life. There's fun of every kind. Next time I come, I'll bring my wife. I'll do that if I lose my mind. A wife in Vegas, take my advice. It's like going to China with a sack of rice. But I love Las Vegas.
You know?
So after, how long did you
after the lights went down?
How much time did you spend with your family?
Oh, during the day.
How much time
did you spend? More time with family. More time with family. Oh, that's cool.
I mean, that's cool. I thought maybe you...
Oh, no. We went to the Mob Museum, and they had Bugsy Siegel sunglasses. Wow. Actual sunglasses. They had the machete that Roy DeMeo chopped up 200 people with.
Whoa, really?
From the Gemini Lounge.
Is that right in downtown Vegas?
Yes.
That's awesome. Yeah. That's cool.
It is an amazing museum, and I would highly suggest everybody going there. It's called the Mob Museum. It's located close to Fremont. I think it's on 3rd.
I applause on the
Vegas. Sure. Oh, yeah. You stayed at downtown?
Yeah, because it was comedy show, yeah.
You're taking the risk?
You know, it's cool. I mean, there was...
It's cool. It's cool. You know what they do have? A zip line that goes through all the way down?
They do?
Fremont? All the way down.
No way, I'm going to go.
High as fuck. It's up there by the...
I don't think they had that open.
It's almost... I've never seen that before either.
That's
it's a zip line that goes all the way... It's right underneath the awning, you know, that shows all that 3D bullshit. Right, you want to do it?
Yeah.
I was asking... And
I didn't even know they had it. I don't think that was open. Wow.
It looks crazy, but it looks fun as fuck, you know? I mean, it doesn't matter.
Did you see people going down it?
Like, no, I saw people waiting in line.
Nobody was what?
I don't know if I wasn't paying attention or I was like, you know, being distracted.
I get excited when I see a zip...
Yeah, no, sorry, you get
a zip line. No, zip lines. I'm like, I get excited like when I see a park that has a zip line. I'm like, oh my gosh. And that's just like a short-ass zip line. That's just like maybe, I don't know, 10 feet. I'm like, oh,
Going over the jungles, the countries that like we just go to vacation, and then we zip line over all the indigenous people, all the poor people.
Not like that, but something about like hanging on to something. Isn't that nice of you? And you just go down like a rope. It almost feels like you're like,
No, because I had an ex-girlfriend, then she did the zip line over like the jungles of like just poor people. I'm all, it's cool and all, but like I could just see these people who live there, and another American just ziplining over them and going, ha ha, fuck you,
They won't buy our fucking guavas, but they'll pay $100 to get this fucking zipline over all of us.
Our trees.
Yeah, real cool.
Thanks.
Motherfucker.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fucking Americans.
Thanks for helping us out.
The worst people. So, the zipline sounds cool. You would go on with me?
Yeah, I love it. I mean,
oh, you get to go all the way down Fremont.
Oh, that's so...
High as fuck.
That fucking... Because I went on like one that went like in Vegas before. Where it takes you up and it like it drops you where you're like going head first, like you're flying like Superman.
That's what you're supposed to look like.
And it was like crazy because when you get up there and you're looking down, it's like
they call it something weird like Slotkowski.
It's really like
Slotzilla. Oh, they call it Slotzillas. That's what they call it. I don't, right? That's kind of dumb, but
I know. But yeah, it's great.
What does that have to do with slots?
Something about like why do we like to be scared like to the point like oh my gosh?
I don't like heights really.
I don't either.
That's why I like to face them. Like,
especially when you're going, like, they're dragging you up, like where you get, where you're going, like, basically you're looking down on as you're going higher. It's scary, even if it's not even that high.
No, 100%.
And I think that's the whole thrill of it. Like, oh my gosh,
Well, you know what I went on? I went on, you know, the stratosphere.
Oh yeah, I never went on that one. Is that one cool?
And it's like just a crane that goes like this. And then you just slide down.
Yeah.
And then it just goes, choom, and then you're over the top of the stratosphere, and you're just looking down. You're like, well, what the fuck? And they keep you there.
Have you ever
skydiving? And right before that, the guy was working on the older Hispanic man, and you could see him like I'm like, oh, if I wasn't so wasted, like he looked like he should not be. Like working on this fucking ride.
He like want to fuck with you too.
He's like, let me turn the screw real quick. And I'm like, my fate of my life is in this guy because I saw it. You know, like it's a very simple ride. It just the crane goes down like this, boom, because it's on the edge of the stratosphere, and then it just goes down like that, and you start from here, and you slide, and then they hang you. You're hanging over the.
Oh, that's cool.
It's cool as fuck. You know the one that they shoot you up? They kind of have a knots, the jump one. They have that up there too, but that ain't shit.
I know. Yeah.
Even at it doesn't matter if it's at the top of the stratosphere, if it's at the if it's at Knott's Berry Farm, it doesn't matter.
No, it doesn't.
That crane thing though. Like it's that's like the scariest ride I've ever been on.
Then you want it even more. Okay, what can I? I want
Sounds
take
like my
it
life.
Up a notch. Take it up a notch.
Sounds like my whole life. Like I was in Vegas. So hey, like let's get back to that. Two nights, passion. And you know what? I was such a better guest the next day, or whatever you want to call it. Like I was such a better person. Looking at the first day, I was kind of like,
"Oh, you're saying goodbye?"
No, but like the first day, you're kind of like, "Oh gosh, right? What's going on? Yeah.
What can I do? What's going on?
Like, I wonder what's going to happen. I wonder what's going to happen tonight.
I hope. What are we going to do tonight?
Yeah.
Okay. Can I go on my own?
No, but we did. We actually family wise, we spent the night playing Uno, and like everybody was in a good mood, and it was a like you wanted to do a time capsule on it.
Yeah, totally.
It was really cool. But then it even got better for me. While everybody else went to bed.
Then dark time comes. Nighttime comes.
Nighttime comes in Vegas.
And the adult comes out.
That's right. At the casino.
I ain't no kid playing Uno anymore.
The casino. And so I met somebody who I didn't know was the whole time was full Hispanic.
Really?
White as white can be.
Wow. Light eyes?
Light eyes, everything.
Wow.
And then somebody else came after.
But then you tasted her and she tasted her.
Yeah. I'm going to get the fuck out of here. No, we actually, like, we talked for a while. And I told her all my hopes and dreams.
Wow.
And she really seemed interested in it, which is the crazy shit. Yeah. Right? She's like, who the fuck is this lunatic? He must have had way too many drinks.
She's like, am I going to get paid right
now? Right. No shit. Right? I go by the hour. Do you know how much this is costing you? But no, but then, and then the second person that came out after, amazing too. Even we just connected on a totally different level.
Absolutely.
I swear to God we did.
Absolutely.
And I wake up at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. I missed breakfast. Summer. I missed.
Is that person gone too?
No. I'm kissing them goodbye.
Wow.
And my parents are coming to the casino at the same time, I guess. And I literally go up to my room, and I'm kissy-kissy. It's a gasser. And as soon as I'm going to go, hey, we're coming up. We're here.
I love Vegas.
Okay. We're going to come up to your room. No, you're not. No, you're not. Do you want to see, like, condoms? Do you want to see bottles of alcohol just thrown around the room?
Well, you know what?
Do you want to see...
Do you want to see your son?
Do
you want to see your son be all lovey-dovey? Because that sounds like you're becoming more...
I'm romantic.
Yeah, you're becoming more...
I am. And so I text her right after. I'm like, oh, well, we just totally missed that one. Because we literally woke up at like 1:30 and like we missed breakfast. We missed... I didn't know that we were supposed to golf that day.
You know what? You're becoming more like... I think you're wanting to settle down.
Well, no. I was happy to. I was happy to go play golf. So let me just tell you the golf story real quick.
Okay.
It's me, my dad, and my amazing cousin Chris. He's such a cool dude.
Is that the younger one? That's.
Well, I mean, there's only one kid.
No, because I mean, thought there's 16.
Boy.
And
there's only one boy.
The other two are daughters.
Yeah, there's three girls and then one boy.
Oh, three girls, one boy.
Three girls, one boy. Right? Okay. Right. And he is just an amazing kid. I mean, they're all amazing.
Wow,
but he's really
sisters.
Cool. And I played golf great. But okay, so we have to rent club. We didn't bring clubs, right?
Yeah.
So it's the resort.
Yeah, of course.
It's right there. It's attached to the casino, kind of.
Okay.
And it's right by my aunt's house, right? So we go there, and there's this man at the pro shop. And my dad, you know, he bought the rounds for or he bought the round. We only did 9 holes, but these holes are like, it's like 500 yards a hole, so it's not like it's a real legitimate golf course. But because I woke up at 2, I guess we only have time for fucking 9 holes. So, but we have to rent our clubs. We have to rent everything, right? I mean, the clubs, the cart, all that shit, right? Obviously, you rent the cart, but whatever. So the guy knows that we don't have nothing.
You're professionals.
Yeah, we're not, right? So I'm like, well, wait a minute, guys. I think we need some gloves. I think everybody needs, and it was Chris's first time ever golfing, which he did amazing. So I buy the gloves, and we got everything we need. 2 carts. We get to the first.
Hey guys, we got a bunch of travelers here from out of town.
And this is what happened with the gloves. I have a pack of, they came in a 2-pack, right? So like, 4 gloves, basically, 2 for $25.
Yeah.
Whoa. And they have 2 gloves in each one. So I'm like, whatever, there's an extra glove. Who cares? So I bring the guy. He goes, "Oh no, dude! No, I got you, dude. Let me get you. This is much cheaper. You just need 3, right? So like, I got that." And he rings it up. It's $50.
Hey guys, we got some guys that are buying.
It's $50.
And the guy that works.
Three gloves.
Some guys are actually buying these fucking gloves.
$50 for 3 gloves. And I look at him, and my dad's in there. And you know how I'm a hothead around my dad. You know, like, because if I feel like, you know, I'm just like on guard, right? Because I'm. Even though my dad was a sheriff, I feel like I got to protect him, right?
Yeah, he's like,
stupid, right?
Yeah,
but I did, and Chris is there. I don't want to act an animal, right? Because I will. I want to reach over and just punch the fuck out of this motherfucker. And I go, okay, $50, cheaper, huh? Okay. And I'd taken everything out of my fucking soul not to rip this guy's face off. You piece of shit. You're a golf idiot. You spend all day in this stupid little room. You fucking dummy. Oh, what do you want to do? Some teas and stuff? Anyways, so we get out to the first hole. Guess what we don't have? Balls? Why the fuck did this guy suggest
that's
that?
That's another $50.
I mean, he knows we're renting everything. Like, we were just trying to get, we don't know this place. We're just trying to gather everything. We don't, you know, we're also too, my dad and mine's minds, you know, we usually have our bags and we always have our stuff. So we just, and then we get, we're like, well, wait a minute. We don't, I have to go back. I said, all right, I'm going to go fucking back to this fucking clubhouse. I'm going to go get the fucking balls. Why the fuck did he not?
Yeah.
Why did he not suggest that? He knows we're renting everything from a golf hat to the goddamn knickers.
Yeah.
Golf shoes. I mean, whatever. We don't have anything. He's rented us everything, but he decided not to suggest the balls.
He's like, yeah, I didn't think you guys were
really being. Yeah. Oh my.
I didn't know. Are you guys serious? guys are really
golfing? It was almost like he was trying to take his stupid golf dick, which is...
Wait a second. You guys are half Mexican and gonna golf?
Yeah, we don't like your kind here.
You really want to golf?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I feel like, you know what, that's funny you said that, because I feel like there was Hispanic hate. Anybody wants to talk about it? Any Hispanic out there that wants to call the Aliente Golf Club in North Nevada, go ahead and call them, because I feel like they hate Hispanic people there.
Do you throw your golf balls out?
You might as well.
Like, is that what you just
said? So I walk back in there like a maniac, but I try to keep it, and I go, hey, can we get some, I think we need some balls.
¿Qué pasó?
I don't even know what balls is in Spanish, but like, my huevos. Hey,
¿qué pasó, amigo?
My huevos. Anyways, no. So I walk in there, I go, hey, do you think you forgot something here? And he goes, well, what do you mean? What'd you possibly? I go, balls? Because I had to drive, because it's such a big course, I had to drive so far. I had to go through I took the shortcut, went through the parking lot, and I'm pissed. I'm just driving over fucking people's cars and shit. No, I like that. But through some parking lot, I took the back route instead of going through the scenic way to get to the first hole. I took this back route. And he goes, and he looks at me like I'm out, like he has no idea.
He says, you mean these nuts?
So he's all, we have these one sleeves, like, you know, and they're like the most expensive ball, you know, those like, maybe it was like five or six.
Yeah,
and I'm like, no, I want the fucking 16 pack, motherfucker, because we're okay. Like the group, like, doesn't matter, all right? We're just playing fucking, we're only gonna be here for like 9 holes.
You know, the balls that you collect off the fucking.
Yeah, basically, give me some fucking, you know, range balls, right? Okay. And he's like, okay, well, that'll be, you know, 55. It was another 45, 50, some shit like that, right? And I don't care. I just.
Oh, I would have said something, because that's like.
Understandable, but my dad had kind of already looked at me before, because, you know, one of the times I went golfing with my dad and friends and all that, and I pretended to. Some people were yelling at us over their awning or whatever from the people who live on the golf course, and they were like talking shit, because a bunch of guys. And so I pretended to get at my drive, and then I just went. As I backed up, I just threw my fucking club, and it literally hit, it came this close to knocking all of them out, but I knew where to hit it, and I told Justin to back the fuck away, and my dad's like, and they started getting pissed. They fucking lost their mind, like, whoa, what are you doing? I'm like, oh, what am I doing? I don't know, I'm just playing golf. I'm sorry, it slipped out of my hand, motherfuckers. What? You guys want to talk some shit? You guys are trying to mess up my fucking drive? You made me lose my club, I guess. I guess I lost my club. Next time, fucking shut the fuck up. Yeah. I go out to the middle of the course. My dad comes over to me. What the fucking shit is that, Steven? What the? Are you out of your fucking mind? You could have, because I could have killed him. Because I went, like, I pretended to do a drive. And I told Justin, and Justin was talking to me like, I'm like, Justin, get the fuck out of the way. Get the fuck out. I'm just, and he's like, what do you mean? What do you mean? I'm going to back up a little bit. Yeah, and so I pretended to swing back. And I just fucking, boom. And I threw my club, and it. I knew where, because there was
an accident. Like,
yeah, a real accident. I knew exactly what I was doing, but I didn't think it was going to get that high, because they're standing over like this. They're in their house and they're drinking beers.
Are you trying to make a point?
They're standing over their ledge, drinking beers and talking shit to everybody that comes up to that hole. Like, they're fucking, I don't know. Like, dude, we're golfing. Come on, man. Like, and I don't care if they want to do that to me. I had younger friends with us too. But you don't talk to my dad deserves respect. He's lived this long. The motherfucker deserves respect.
Dad's like, I fucking have my respect. I was a fucking sheriff. God,
yeah,
damn,
but he,
I fucking,
no,
fuck
my dad
that.
Was furious.
I don't need my fucking son to protect
every,
my
all the all the guys. Glenn hated me, but Justin and his buddy, they were like high five at me, like, that was pretty fucking badass. That was, because it scared the shit out of them. Like, they were really pissed off.
Yeah, your dad's like,
he's all, Steven, I don't know if I want to fucking golf with you.
I fucking gave my life fucking.
Yeah, I gave my life to give you a good life. Fucking, and now you almost ruined it.
I didn't even want kids, but your mom was so fucking adamant about having one. And I fucking said, okay, I did it. Right. I did it. All right, fine.
And you just
Jeannie,
almost
I love
ruined
you.
It.
I'll do it. But you know what? This ain't gonna fucking stand.
No, he was pissed.
I mean, I draw the fucking line. Jazz classes, all that other fucking.
And I looked at him. I looked at
bullshit.
Him. I looked at him like a crazed maniac at that time. I said, Dad, I just don't want anybody to think they're better than us.
Your dad's like, motherfucker, I don't know about you, but I know. And your dad's like, motherfucker, I know I'm better. I don't know about the fuck.
Yeah, basically. You don't need it.
You could take your tap dances, your jazz lessons, and all that other fucking shit, but motherfucker, I have been a fucking... I've been through...
You have no idea what I've been through.
I mean...
Because a couple of hecklers.
The tough shit I had to do.
You?
It's fucking you. And I'm going to tell you right now, if you ever pull this shit again, I ain't your mom, motherfucker. I ain't your mom. I'm not going to fucking sugarcoat it. Listen, you ever fucking pull that shit again, I will fuck you up.
Straight up. That is exactly. Megan. Wow. You fucking nailed
it. I think I said that to my own kid.
So anyways, so back to the real stuff. That was years ago, right? So that's why I didn't create a scene.
Exactly.
So I drive back, balls. We end up having a fucking amazing time. Chris actually is doing, it's the first time golfing out on the course.
That's good.
Long holes. He's actually doing very, very, better than I did in my first time.
Athlete, yeah.
Yeah, he was a natural athlete. Like, you know, my dad's instructing him. And I was playing so well that whatever my dad would instruct him,
yeah,
I would actually do in real life.
Yeah.
So he could see it.
Yeah.
Which was surprising to me because I know I've been practicing a lot more. And, you know, it's like it's all, after 20 years of golf, it's finally coming together for me. Okay. So anyways, one of the holes, I nail it perfectly down the middle. And I go up to my ball and there's a bird like maybe maybe 2 feet, not even 2 feet away, a foot and a half. Just curled up. And I go, wait a minute, that bird looks like it's...
I can't...
And I'd seen the flock of seagulls, or whatever they are, flock of birds, whatever. And Shane said, my buddy Shane, friend of the show Shane, said, hey, you got a baby. The thing was done. Yeah, I'm upset too because my ball could have gone farther had it not been in the way of that. That's what I'm upset about. So, I know. How could you do that ever if you try it? I mean, there's no way. And I'm like, did I really do it? Oh, it's fresh. There's nobody on the golf course. We're the only people. There's not people in front of us. There's not people behind us. There's nobody. Absolutely. That was my ball.
That's crazy.
I understand. But I felt bad too. And I'm like, hey guys, I kept yelling, I think I killed a bird. Like, I felt really bad.
Yeah, can we?
And everybody was like, hey, come on, we gotta go.
Can we make up the ending on the story and say, like, oh yeah, you went over there?
No,
and
you're
like,
it gets better.
And the bird, it all of a sudden woke up and flew away. Can we,
I kissed it.
Can we do that?
I kissed it to make it better.
Can we do that story?
The bird was gonna drive off a cliff, and then I kissed it and made it better.
You would be like, hey, my bird was actually going to die, but then I just...
Yeah, but all I said is, hey, do you need me to kiss you?
I gave a little peck. I gave a little kiss.
Oh, peck. I gave a little peck. Because my kisses heal. You know that, right? I think you heard that from somebody before.
I did. I heard that. Your kisses provide...
They may taste like
life
peppercorn.
Life-altering, like life, basically, you give life with your kisses.
I stop all kinds of tragedies. I give life, even if it tastes like peppercorn.
Yeah, they might be dead, but when you kiss them, all of a sudden they spring back to life.
Like a lesbian spring. So, anyways. So we're on the seventh. We're everybody's golfing. We're finally, you know, and Chris is doing great. And it's like, it's an amazing time.
I can't wait till you find out who wins.
We're on the seventh hole. And we're right about close to the green. And I'm just about to hit. And I'm playing fucking fantastic. Game. Every fucking sprinkler. And it's 6 o'clock. The lights are on. 6:20. 6:30 maybe. Every goddamn sprinkler that shoots harder than a fucking laser beam.
I knew you were going to come over there.
Hitting all of us. All of a sudden, who the fuck? We're the only ones out there. This motherfucker.
What was the score? You must not have won.
No. It has nothing to do with the score. It's the seventh hole, and we still have time to finish. Like, it's daylight out. It's because 6:30 right now is daylight.
Yeah, it's totally.
You can't fucking turn on the sprinklers at 8:30 when everybody's gone? And when it's no. I'm thinking it's just one. So we have to battle. My cart's getting wet. My phone in my pocket. I mean, I'm getting so, but I want to hit all of us. And I hear Chris and my dad on the other side going, oh God, oh shit, fuck, they're all running with it, but they're having fun with it. Kind of, because we think it's only going to be at one hole. Oh, maybe it's this one hole they turn on the sprinklers. Yeah. We can't putt because it was too much. Like we tried, we had to get the fuck out of there because it was, I'm telling you, these things popped up out of the ground. So I start throwing fucking things at the sprinklers. I want to smash these motherfucking sprinklers.
All right, somebody keep a point down?
Yeah. But it's not, has nothing to do with the score.
Okay, I want to see what the score is going to be at the end.
Oh, no. I mean, I probably won because I was playing really good. I mean, Chris is the first time.
I know, but it's the first time.
I bogeyed like every hole, which is pretty good.
Sprinklers coming on that didn't throw like a little
Yeah, you know who put him on? You know who put him on, I think? I mean, I'm on the side to get away from these fingers. I'm thinking, this motherfucker. The golf pro shop fucking asshole. Ball washing fucking idiot. I did say when I was in the pro shop, I did say, oh, don't worry, I recorded him. Like, this guy's done or something like that. I did say that.
Oh,
I said something like that.
You said that's the word. You can hear me.
Yeah, you hear me. So we get to the eighth hole. That was the sixth hole. We get to the seventh hole. Thinking that, all right, maybe they turn the sprinkler on. It's just, you know, timers, whatever they are. Now every, I mean, it doesn't matter. The whole course now is launched with the hardest. There's no way. They popped up out of nowhere. Like, sprinklers you didn't even think should even be there. There's, I don't, because it's, you know, it's, what is that? It's Vegas. So you have to have, like, drought resistant shit. They're even sprinkling the fucking, the rocks.
You hear a voice from the distance. Yeah, motherfucker, try golfing now. Fuck. Yeah, it sounds, wow.
I couldn't even concentrate. And my dad could see it in me. I start losing my mind. Like, I'm like, he's all, Steven, don't. We'll just play through it. We'll try to play through it. We didn't. We couldn't. We had to end it.
So you missed out a really second.
So we paid for 9 fucking holes, which probably was like not that cheap because it's a resort. I don't know what my dad paid, right?
You must have a really scary looking face. Oh, if your dad told you.
Oh. But I didn't want to do anything in front of Chris.
Please don't do.
100%. I didn't want to do anything. I don't want to show. I mean, so. But Chris could. I'm like, oh, I'm all that mother.
I know he's used to traumatize you, but I don't. I'm not gonna over.
So we get there. The guy's gone, and there's like some piece of shit. Fucking, are you gonna bring your card in?
Steven, don't do it. Steven, don't do it.
Yeah, they still. He's all. I forgot they have my ID. Yeah, we got your ID.
Steven, don't do it. Yeah, don't do it. Steven, you're already right.
So they bring it out, and I ripped the fucking ID out of this. Guys, and I don't know who this fucking another mongoloid. I mean, there's so many in my life.
Did your dad have to tell you?
100%.
Please, don't.
At least.
How many?
15 times.
Oh shit!
But like, we didn't do it in front of Chris.
Then I don't think I've really seen that great. Wow.
I was furious because I felt that it was a personal against to me. This is the only time we ever get with this with our cousin and my dad. How many times more can I golf with him? I don't know. Tomorrow's never promised. And this motherfucker robbed me of that shit. So that's what I'm thinking in my head.
Yeah.
Like, almost like you're like, you're a golf pro. Would anybody miss you?
That's where he does worry.
Would anybody miss you, golf pro? I don't think so. I think anybody could do your fucking job.
You're absolutely right.
You can speak English? Okay. Barely? You could do it.
Please, Steven, don't do it. Don't do it.
So then we walk over to the hotel where I'm staying at, yes, you know, because it's right part of it. And Chris is walking, and he could tell I'm upset. And I'm like, Chris, it's okay, man. And all of a sudden, he flips the bird to some car that almost takes us out for no reason. And I'm like, why would you do that? He goes, dude, she flipped me off, like, for no reason. Like, she flipped us. I'm like, we're just walking across the... This is like 7:30. And my dad and I were like, oh, what the hell? Why is Chris... And he's like the nicest kid. He's like, dude, you guys don't understand. Like, and the way he said it, like, I could tell that the lady was a maniac and just flipped us off for no reason. It was like, maybe it was the wife of the golf pro guy. I don't fucking know. That just wanted, it was the gnarliest shit ever. And we all calmed down. We had a nice dinner at one of the restaurants there at the casino. Very nice. It ended up being, we were all laughing about it because we have to tell the story to my mom and my aunt as we're sitting there, you know, in the restaurant, and they're howling, and they're like, did you guys have a good time at least or what? And I'm like, no, we had an amazing time, but you wouldn't think though, because of this story that I'm telling, it's fucking crazy. Alejante, North Vegas. I promise you, I will make sure that you guys get shut down for fucking, I don't know, child molestation. Is that what that goes on over there? Is that what they do there?
Overcharging balls.
I think that guy might have been a child molester.
Yeah, or
he looked like he had that child molester face.
Oh, he did. He had the glasses too.
He just looked disgusting. I don't think he's just serving balls.
Well, how much they charged you?
I don't. $100 for a couple of golf.
What?
For balls and three gloves.
In Vegas.
That's okay. I understand that. But don't tell me you're going to do me a favor when I already saw the deal for $25.
Are the balls made out of diamonds?
Yes, they were. They're diamond club. You got to get out of here.
They were diamond balls?
Yeah, they're diamond balls. Like, yeah, diamond, yeah, yeah. Ba.
No, it just reminds me of basically wherever you go, if you're like not like living in that neighborhood.
I think that they punk everybody there.
They
you know
will
why?
Take advantage of you like nothing else.
Yeah, right? I have no idea what. And so my dad would be.
They can spot people.
I'm going to visit Aunt D. I'm going to visit.
Like, oh, this person ain't from Vegas.
Yeah, we know. I definitely don't look like I'm from Vegas. I know that.
Let's double. You know what we do? Hey, bro. Hey, you know what we do? You know, charge them.
Yeah. Hey, you see that $25 thing over there? I got you.
That was from last week. It's $50.
No, but the thing is, he said that I got the better deal for you. Three gloves. You don't need all those gloves.
Hey, you part Mexican, right? I do.
Yeah. Hispanic hate. Hashtag Hispanic hate.
Moraga, that's like a. I
definitely think that
I got a cousin last name Moraga. I'll give you the deal.
No, he's definitely not Mexican.
I'll give you the $50.
They hate
deal.
Mexicans there. They actually hate Mexicans there.
Hey, I'll give you half price, $50.
Yeah, some fucking gloves. So real quick, I want to let everybody know. Last episode, Ms. Meg Lee did what you know what she does for you. She calls into the cast because we had to get it released in Vegas. I edited it, put it out. But we did it last week, and mm-hmm. you were such a like a saint, like Mother Teresa.
And also thank you,
Mother Teresa.
Speaking of Teresa, thank you for all the girls that did submit, like their.
Oh, that's interesting.
And that was like, and
I wish he would have been picked. Anybody
ultimately,
else.
Stephen was just joking around. He did have a great time.
Yeah,
because he did tell me.
Well, the sushi was good.
He did, and in fact, he did tell me that he did try to bust a move on Teresa, but. Teresa actually was the one that turned him down. So we were just making jokes, but yeah, we know what's up.
Teresa,
yeah.
You're right. Teresa turned a cheek. But I just want to say thank you though for calling in. I know it was maybe to everybody out there, you're not used to Ms. Meg Lee is in studio, and you know, I wish we could record this for everybody to jerk off to. But but she called in and on the old Skype in her car, and then yeah. The next day, what she does for the community, what she does for you. Which you can go to patreon.com/whatstheplay and contribute to her battery. Because she was in the car, and the next day she knew that the battery was getting low on her, not on her cell phone, in the rain, or was it raining? No, it was raining.
Yeah, because I had to turn my car on in order to charge my phone. That was the only way I could charge it.
To talk to us.
To talk, yeah, to keep on, yeah, because, and I guess from leaving it on, or partway on, because I get. Anyways, I would get the message saying, oh, your battery's gonna, I don't know, die or something. But I thought, like, oh, whatever, it's not gonna die in this car. I've seen that message before, it's cool. Well, I guess it did die. So, because after I turned off everything and I went back inside, I came back out the next morning, and it was dead. My battery was.
You,
but
you had
AAA,
to call.
Thank you, though.
So, AAA had to bail you out for doing these things for the people.
They had to charge up with the whole, what do you call those?
Batteries?
The little crank things that you put on the
battery.
They have to jump start it.
Yeah. There you go, jump start. So, you know what you did today? You jump started everybody's life. And I think everybody should be appreciative.
You. But you forgot to mention one thing. You were going to try eating. You were going to actually try eating what I brought for you.
Oh,
time.
Shit.
Yeah. And this was a low-carb chicken pot pie. Yeah. Microwave it, take the foil off. Yeah. Probably like a couple minutes.
So we all know that Ms. Meg Lee is not only a giver to the audience, but she's about to give you the greatest cuisine the world has ever known for.
I'm trying, yeah. For a low-carb lifestyle, for like, because most people are either pre-diabetic or diabetic in this nowadays.
In this sugar-filled world.
And you know what? It sucks because it's like, the sugar basically will either make you look older, it ages you, and it also
Teresa must have had some of that.
Gives you your blood sugar levels, like, will go, and nobody knows it, really, because nobody really, even if you're younger, like, nobody realizes the danger, because I always think, oh, what's the danger of sugar? And the sugar actually, like, speeds up the aging process. It also makes your blood sugar high, and what people don't understand is blood sugar levels, when they're high, it makes your blood thicker. So when you have thicker blood, it leads to heart attacks and strokes. So basically.
And a variety of other things. Diabetes, like you said, cut your legs off. When you get diabetes, you have to cut your legs off.
Not only that, but like people don't think, oh, chairs are my legs for size.
Right.
Well, it's not just because, okay, yeah, you have limbs that have your circulation problem, but people don't realize that people, it'll cause strokes and heart attacks.
Right.
And if you get a stroke or a heart attack,
then you're
say you live for it, you're probably going to be brain dead or
not the same person anymore.
Exactly. And it's scary because nobody really tells you, like, oh, high blood sugar means, like, it's worse than smoking, worse than
drinking.
It's so bad, and people don't realize it because you could be, it could just be like, you could be skinny for all people that are like, no, like, they have no worries, like, never had a problem with their weight. You could still be diabetic, and that's the problem. There's a lot of people that are really thin and don't have the typical, like, body of a diabetic, they could still be at risk of a heart or stroke. I mean, a heart attack or stroke. It's horrible. But either way, I'm just saying, so people that don't look like they could be diabetes can still be diabetic.
Yeah, like, you won't know you have diabetes until your legs fall off.
And not know it. And then they'll go about their life thinking, oh, I'm cool, man.
Yeah.
I weigh 100 pounds. I'm only...
Yeah. But I love trolley sugar
and I could drink and eat all the sweets I want. But guess what? You might not wake up the next day because...
Because
you were diabetic and you never knew it.
Diabetic sugar coma.
And I'm just saying, it sucks.
So because of that, you have...
I've been trying to come out with, because I am pre-diabetic. I had...
No, you're not.
When I was pregnant, I had...
Oh, that's why.
You know?
Because it's not your diet. You eat...
And now they say, you know, like, when you ever... Yeah, because even Halle Berry had...
Well, Halle Berry had it.
She had gestational diabetes, but it turned into diabetes. Because sometimes it'll do that.
I think that's from all the men that beat her. I think they beat the sugar.
Like anybody can turn diabetic.
Sugar, give me some sugar.
And she was, but I'm sure she probably turned diabetic just because she's so awful.
Yeah, I bet she's a horrible person.
But people out there that think that aren't horrible, like, if you ever feel like a warm feeling throughout your body, that probably means your blood sugar's high.
Oh, shit.
And you should.
I thought it was semen.
And you should probably, like, you know, always get checked, and you should probably go to your doctor to check.
All right, but so what are you doing? What are you doing?
I'm trying to come out with something that, because everything that's good, everything that tastes good in life is usually high sugar, high carbs, whatever. Nobody makes good food or good sweets that actually can be good for you, as far as, like, carb-wise, sugar-wise. So I've been trying to come out with stuff that's comparable to the best sweets and food dishes out there that's usually high carb, high sugar. I've been trying to come out with stuff that's very low carb, no sugar.
Whoa.
And
wait, you're telling me, hold on, Ms. Migley. Yeah. You're telling me.
I know my chicken. You got to know you a chicken. I know my chicken. You got to know you a chicken. I know my chicken.
Right now, that you have made a couple dishes that have no sugar.
Yeah.
Absolutely no sugar.
No sugar. They have, like, sugar. Yeah.
So I know that you have a pasta, right?
Tuna cabbage. Instead of noodle, it's tuna cabbage casserole.
Right. And that thing was amazing.
Yeah. Very low carb and no sugar.
And no sugar.
No sugar.
And I'm about to try right now. What is this?
This is a mini chicken pot pie, which has a very low carb crust.
I know my chicken. You got to know you a chicken.
Made with almond flour and cheeses, no regular flour, so it's very low in sugar, but no sugar actually, really, and very low carbs. It only has 4 grams of carbs for that whole thing, and the sugar is
not even on the radar.
Yes.
Wow. So I'm about to try this. Ms. Megley brought this here to the studio. What we're going to do is we're going to present it to you either through Twitter, on Facebook, on all of our different platforms. We're going to make sure that you guys get the opportunity to have, to live.
And I figure you're the more judgmental person when it comes to food, because used to... I've been used to, like, I know what, like, sugar, like, it tastes a little different, and some people might not... Mm-hmm. Used to that adjustment in, like...
Well, I don't know. I ate that pasta like
it's
pussy.
Yeah, you know. Yeah, you like... So...
I ate that pasta like it's pussy. I think that's your tagline. I ate that thing up cold, and I'm like, I still wanted more.
And that was really easy to make, too. Like,
it's not easy to make because it's made with your care. So, Ms. Meg Lee's home cooking for people that don't want to die. It's coming at you.
I still want good.
But still want good, hearty, tasting meals. Right now, I'm about to try this flaky crust. I'm looking at this pot pie. It's a mini pot pie, which is interesting because usually the pot pies that you get at restaurants are obese. And they're just like the people usually eat them.
A little
butter crust. Right?
Yeah.
Oh, cool. Good job. But no, but you're making mini ones. But these mini ones.
They're based on our childhood.
Right.
What would you
have with? Mega Moffitt.
Yes, Moffitt.
Right. We'll mainly contribute to Miss Meg Lee's cooking. She's going to have a show coming up pretty soon.
Cooking.
Right. And she's going to show you the ways to live a healthy lifestyle. However, tasty life. It doesn't mean.
Because like the best things like are so bad. And I get it because I love sweets and I love sugar. Mm-hmm. But I want to come out with something that could, you can get the same satisfaction without having to sacrifice
God.
Your limbs.
I know my chicken. You got to know you are chicken. I know my chicken. You got to know you are chicken. I know my chicken.
God, I wish that was, there's so many things in my life that I wish you could just cure like that. All right, here we go.
Okay.
Ms. Megley, this is holy fuck. Fuck. You know what you? I don't know what you do with it. With your.
Bacon, you're telling me bacon and chicken and just celery and a little bit of carrots. Yeah.
Oh, I don't even know.
The dough is actually just almond flour and mozzarella cheese.
I got yelled at by like my last girlfriend.
Yeah.
She said I eat like I fucking have never seen food before. I was like, I don't know what it is with you, but you always smack your fucking. And right now I'm smacking because I love this shit.
Oh, okay, good. Because I was like, you know, like getting it from the middle. Okay, good.
That's good.
Yeah? Okay. Cool.
I can't believe. You're telling me right now.
The crust is almond flour and mozzarella cheese.
So when I eat this, like my blood sugar will not rise.
No. It's very low carbs.
You have a crust on it, though. How the fuck did you do that?
The crust is maybe just cheese and olive oil.
Wow, that's good as fuck. Yeah. Damn. God. Like, and there's so much flavor to it.
Yeah, but like it's bacon and chicken in there. Because bacon gives it to it extra like flavor to it, you know? Yeah.
It looks like exploding with flavor right now.
Cool.
I think I just went down to Flavor Town. Wow, that's fucking amazing.
Good? Okay, cool. And the crust doesn't taste like it's like a low carb crust, you know?
If you would have told me that it was just a normal crust or whatever. Yeah. If you told me just whatever, I made this little pot pie. And they're not little by any means. Like you eat one of these,
4-inch diameter. Yeah,
you'll be full.
Yeah,
but depending on if you need them for your parties, depending if you need them for just you like a romantic evening, you know, ladies, you want to say you're not Teresa, and you want to impress somebody.
Uh-huh.
Hey, I made these here, and you won't have to lose your limbs in 2 years. No, I'm just no, but
yeah,
for real,
yeah.
It is so delicious, this baby.
Yeah, okay.
So proud of you. I didn't try your cheesecake. They're perfected. So I think right now there's 3 items that people can order. Get your orders in because God damn it, this is fucking good. We have a pasta.
Cabbage noodle casserole, tuna casserole, blueberry cheesecake,
and
chicken pot pie, mini chicken pot pies.
Megan's.
It has bacon in it, just for people that right. It could be done without.
They just have to give you a heads up.
Is the other white meat?
Mm-hmm. Except for Muslims.
And pork, and pigs. If you have pigs, they will eat you.
Mm-hmm. So remember that.
They will eat anything. Mm. So if you want to, like, you know, turn it up, like.
Yeah, anybody owns a pig farm, watch out for them.
I had a pet pig, and I thought, like, well, my pig would eat me. So I thought, like, oh.
I'll eat you, motherfucker. No, Megan, this is amazing.
Is it good?
It's so good. Yeah. Holy shit.
Cool,
no, but you know what it also tastes like? It just tastes like
the crust
something
like
I don't get a lot.
Like, being like a regular crust, it tastes like
chewy. No, the crust is amazing.
You know, sometimes like, we have something that's
and
like,
really the crust is no, the crust is amazing. But I'm saying
sure
like yeah. They blend.
Like the same kind of texture or like you know, totally. Some people like you know they have low carb,
right?
Because
a lot of times, yeah,
the crust isn't like a regular, you know.
No, the crust is great.
Oh, yeah.
But even better is the inside.
Yeah.
It tastes like because I you know I'm a bachelor.
Yeah.
And I don't get home-cooked meals.
Mm-hmm.
And this tastes like legitimately like a mother's blanket over your heart.
Yeah, it's cooking.
It just seems like home cooked, like.
Yeah. It was. It was very, like, it took a. Yeah.
I'm devouring it right
that
now.
That one I did take, like, some time in, but, like, it was.
And I love the size of it. Because those other Popeyes are just so obese. But I can put no sugar, lowest carbs you're ever going to find.
Yeah.
Miss Meg Lee. We're going to, if this sounds amazing to you, just email us at steven@whocaresthepodcast.com or go to our Facebook page, or you can just find me Instagram, Maraga Steven, or go to Facebook, What's the Play. There's so many ways. What's the Play on Twitter? Who Cares the Podcast on Twitter?
You know what I
however
do?
You want to get a hold of
me. I want to get your mom to try it because your mom is even more, like.
She knows down. She knows down.
Yeah, so, like. And you know what? I'm going to bring some more stuff for her and try it.
Well, everybody should try this. Miss Meg Lee, always, you have a gift, and you better share this goddamn gift with the world.
Yes, well, I want people to try it, so.
I know my chicken. You got to know you a chicken. I know my chicken. You got to know you a chicken. I know my chicken.
For real, like, there's, like, you know, I hear the little knock. Hey, Steven, it's noon. But, hey, how much longer are you going to sleep, huh? No, but, and then I'm like, all right, I'll come out.
Like, I thought I was on vacation.
can you just give me a minute? But like, I already have, like, your eggs and your ham and your bacon and your sausage and your fruit.
You don't want to get cold?
Yeah, you definitely don't want to get cold.
Yeah.
And I said, I don't care.
Your dad's already finished his food.
3 hours ago. And he's next door. You didn't, she was a lesbian, was she?
She's down.
Do they even own that place anymore? Or were they renters? I bet they were renters. I don't think they live there.
I think some real homeowners. The first girl that I knew. That,
I think some homeowners live there now.
Back in eighth grade, that shaved
her face?
With a razor.
Oh my God. She had to shave her face? I'll just leave that.
Everybody plays the fool. There's no point in wondering why people do what they do. It's alright to be confused, but don't lose sight of the truth. Girl, it's him, it's not you. So what if he don't call when he's supposed to? So what if he don't care? So what if when you cry he don't hold you? You don't need him to be there. So what if when you're mad he says you're crazy? You just make him insecure. No, you didn't know the girl you used to be. You just let yourself get a little hurt. But so what? So what if he don't call when he's supposed to? So what if he don't care? So what if when you cry he don't hold you? You don't need him to be there. Oh, oh, oh. So what if when you're mad he says you're crazy? You just make him insecure. No, you didn't lose the girl you used to be. You just let yourself get a little hurt. So what?